what's up everyone? My name is Donovan. This is the Huawei Band 2 Pro, and tonight I want to share with you a runner's perspective on this super affordable GPS watch. So what do I mean by super affordable? Right now, it's available for $50 at gearbest.com, which is a fantastic deal for a GPS watch like this one. On Amazon right now, it's actually $70. So I'll also leave that link down below as well. But I did want to mention that not only is this watch on sale, but also there's a ton of other great deals going on at gearbest.com, and when you check out those links and purchase something from Gearbest, it does help out the channel. So definitely check out those deals below. So now let's go ahead and talk about the Huawei Band 2 Pro. So first thing I want to mention is that there's three things I don't like about this watch. Number one is this. So I'm going to go ahead and go into the running mode, or the outdoor run mode. So here we go. So you're going to long press the button. There's only a single button down here, and it's going to jump into GPS, as you can see here. So now it's searching for GPS, and generally if you're outside, it takes about 20 to 30 seconds. So that's pretty typical, not bad. However, the one thing I don't like about it, and this is pretty unfortunate, and that is as soon as it collects GPS, it's going to give you a 3-second countdown, and then you need to be on your way. So unfortunately, if you're in a race, let's say you want to, you don't know exactly when that race is going to start. Well, unfortunately, when this gets to zero, there's no way to pause it, and basically you just need to be out and you need to be running. So hopefully the clock starts at the exact same time on the watch as it does in your race, but it is what it is. So the countdown's a little bit annoying. I wish there was a way to pause it. So that's number one thing I don't like about it. Number two is, unfortunately, the GPS is not particularly accurate. And what I mean by that is that it's very, very consistent. Literally, it is easy, like clockwork, you're able to figure out exactly what's wrong with it. And this is at least for me, and it's been very, very consistent. And that is, it's always giving me an extra 5%. So in other words, when I'm going for a 5-mile run, it gives me 5.25 miles. Basically, it adds 5/100ths to every mile that I run. So if I'm running 1 mile, it gives me 1.05. At 2 miles, it's 2.10, and so on and so forth. So it's not particularly good in that regard, which is really unfortunate, because that also means that your pace is a little bit off on here as well. So that's reason number two that I don't like it. It's very consistent, but unfortunately it's consistently off. And number three is, this LCD display that you see here is actually kind of hard to see, especially when you're running in bright daylight. Now, in casual, you know, just day to day, when you turn it on or you flick your wrist to turn it on, it's just fine. You can really see it. If you know, it's going to be harder to see in bright daylight, but you can still see it. However, if you're running and your wrist is kind of moving up and down while you're running, so that, first of all, the numbers are kind of small, but secondly, the LCD is not particularly bright, and so it's hard to see for both of those reasons combined. So that's number three, and that's kind of really an unfortunate thing, because I typically really like Huawei products, but unfortunately I'm not sure I can really recommend this, at least for runners. Now, when it comes to every other thing about this watch, I really think it's actually quite good. Unfortunately, the one thing that's really not good is the thing I really want it for, which is GPS tracking for my running. So now let's go ahead and talk about all of the other features. So as far as build quality goes, I think it's great. It's a pretty typical activity tracker. We have our heart rate sensor on the back, which I will say is very, very good. In terms of battery life also, that's very good. I believe that they claim, what is it, on the back, they say here maybe 21 days of daily use. So that's if you're not using GPS. If you're using GPS, you're definitely not going to get 21 days. I've found that over the last 6 days that I've been using it, I'm down to 40%. So typically about 10% per day. And out of those 6 days, I've gone for 4 runs with this watch. So that's not too bad. I think that kind of battery life is very good for a watch like this. So let's talk about some of the other things that they mention here. So obviously we already talked about the GPS. You can use it for swimming because it is waterproof 5 ATM, which basically means 164 feet underwater. So unless you're deep sea diving, you're going to be just fine with this watch. I've wore it in the shower, in the lake, no problems in any of those situations. Accurate continuous heart rate, that is very true. The heart rate even during a run is very accurate. With some watches, you find that during the day, the heart rate is pretty accurate, but when you go out for a run and you get sweaty, it's not very accurate. But with this one, it is very, very accurate. So I really like that. The heart rate is great. It says first beat running guidance. So it gives you some VO2 max and training effect information. So that's just going to tell you, like, for instance, my VO2 max, it said was 58, which is supposed to be pretty good. And my training effect was 4.4. And I really have no idea what that even means. So I probably should study up on that one. So scientific sleep tracking, it does a great job with sleep tracking. And I'll show you that in just a little bit. It also has some breathing instructions, and you can actually see that right on the watch. And then it does also give you smart notifications, call messages, and then also smart alarms as well. So what that smart alarm does is it wakes you up kind of in the peak of your sleep. Not really in the peak of your sleep, but at the peak moment during your sleep, so that you can get kind of like the most restful kind of sleep possible. So that is the things it does. So the other thing I want to mention here is the app. Oh, and there it is on gearbest.com. Let's see if we can get that into focus. So there it is for $50. Like I mentioned, it's currently on sale. So I'm going to go ahead and go out of that. And now we're going to go into the app. So it's going to use an app called Huawei Health. It's available on iOS and on Android. So I have it here on my OnePlus 6 here. So first thing you're going to see is this kind of like your main page. So it's going to show steps. It's going to show the different exercises that you've done. So I'll go into one of those real quick just so you can kind of see. So this was a run I did earlier tonight. It said 6.42 miles. It's actually closer to like 6.1 or 6.2. But the GPS map is actually dead on. It went exactly, all the GPS maps that I've done so far were dead on. This was just a run down a railroad track. And the reason I did that was to get, I used it on a course that I was very, very familiar with. All the mile markers are marked out. And unfortunately, you know, it gave me a longer distance than what I actually ran. And so it said I ran at 6 minutes and 40 seconds per mile. And it was probably closer to like 6:50 per mile. And that's simply because of the fact that the distance is off. So now let's go up here. You can see the pace. So it gives you your pace per mile. It shows you your heart rate. And of course, that's very accurate, like I mentioned. Then it shows you kind of like your zones in terms of your heart rate, so that's all great. And then details, it kind of breaks it down, and here you can see where's it at. So there's the training results, so you can see 4.4 like I mentioned, VO2 max 58 like I was saying earlier. It's recommending that I take 45 hours of break, but if you're a runner, obviously you're probably not breaking for 2 days before you're running. Some people do, but that's just not me. All right, so everything about the app I really like. I think this readout here, this is the same app that you use if you have the Huawei Band 2, or sorry, the Huawei Watch 2, which I thought was a great watch. So then we come down here and there's our sleep tracking. Again, that's very great. I think it works really well. The heart rate, again, is very accurate. Then you can see here, if we go into devices, so this is where you're actually going to adjust your notifications and things like that. So you can enable your true sleep, you can enable your all day heart rate, and that does obviously affect the battery. But again, I'm getting like about 10% per day. We can set up some alarms here, do not disturb. Here's our notification management, so you can adjust what apps give you notifications. So I'm not going to go in and, you know, show you all those, but basically every app that you have on your phone can give you notifications. But I've only set it so that phone calls and messages give me notifications, because I just don't like getting everything on my watch, because that's just really disturbing throughout a day. Let's get that back into focus. All right, so then we can also let it know whenever we've lost Bluetooth connection to our phone, and you can see some other things that it does here as well. There's our smart raise wrist to wake up the screen and things like that. So all that is really great. No issues there whatsoever. All of that stuff is very good. All right, so in the end, is this a watch that I can recommend to friends and family? And honestly, I'm just gonna go ahead and say, not really. And I already mentioned the three things I don't really like about the watch. And unfortunately for me as a runner, those are just three things that I really can't get past. Now, what I will say is that instead of getting this watch, I can recommend another watch that really is pretty close in price and honestly fix every issue that I have here. The GPS is accurate. The LCD is super easy to see. In fact, the brighter the light, this has a trans-reflective display. So this one actually fixes that. It has a much better battery life, so you can get 20 to 45 days actually of battery life on this watch. And then the other issue I had was with the countdown. That's not an issue with this one either. So this is the Amazfit Bip. It's a little bit more expensive. It's about $60, somewhere between $60 and $65 on gearbest.com. So definitely check this one out. I'm gonna leave a link down in the description for this watch as well. Fantastic GPS watch, super affordable, and one that I would definitely recommend to anybody and everybody that's looking for a nice, affordable GPS running watch. So anyways, this is the Amazfit Bip. This is a video on the Huawei Band 2 Pro. Not a recommendation for me. So anyways, thanks for watching. I hope this video has been helpful for you, and I will see you all in the next one. Peace.